is the concept of vision, mission clear to everybody? Anybody has a doubt? Now I'll make the vision statement for my life. You please think over and make a statement for your life. Okay. What is the vision you have for your life? And then how to accomplish that, what are the issues there, how you solve personal problems is what we discuss in the next coming sessions. So I will make a statement of my vision. Right? My vision is to bring peace and happiness to everybody in the world. With the unique skill which I have, with the unique skill which I have as a teacher of spiritual enlightenment. You have to discover first your unique skill. What is the unique skill which you have, which is very special for you? With that, you have to bring, I want to bring peace and happiness to everybody in the world. So that is the vision which I have. That's the vision which makes me wake up every day. In fact, if you see me, if I have to go to office, my energy will not come. If I have to go and teach, my whole energy will come. Even if I have fever, I will come and teach. Okay? And get energized by your vision. So you have to have a vision which energizes you, which makes you jump out of the bed. Right? Understand? Which makes you feel energized even in any difficulties, get up and do that. Nobody should come and tell you, do this. That is the vision. Vision is something which does not allow to sleep. If the energy is so high that you don't sleep. In fact, before coming to this class yesterday, okay, yesterday we started, right? On Thursday night, I slept at 2 o'clock and got up at 4:30. Okay? Right? Actually, if you are able to sit with me, I will continue this class for 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock. Not for your benefit, I am closing the class earlier. If energy is flowing through you, that means your vision is proper. Okay? You have to understand some principles of universe. Universe will give you something, energy, whatever is required, whatever you are actually capable of doing. For example, let's say you want to go from one city to other city, right? Okay? Let's say you want to go from Bangalore to, let's say, Mysore. Okay? How many liters of petrol is required in your car? Some 20 liters, 25 liters, sufficient. If 20, 25 liters is there, you won't feel extra. You go. The fuel or energy which is given to you, is which you use for the vehicle, is to the extent it's what job it's performing. Similarly, the fuel and energy which God gives to you is to the extent what job you are performing. The machine, vehicle. The greater the job you are performing, greater the energy will flow through you. Not only flow through you, everything which is required for the energy will come to you. That is the universal law. Okay? So I am just saying, each of us has to struggle for our survival, existence, no doubt about that. Do that. Now, how you grow beyond that is I am trying to teach you. Everybody does that. And everybody makes justification also. I am doing a job and I am doing a service. My dear, whether you do a service or compulsion, anything you have to do. So what you have to do is dictated by the world. What you want to do is your vision. Something beyond that. Vision doesn't come, it doesn't happen. It gets created by you. It's you have to create the vision. It's your energy which comes into that. And as your energy becomes one with the universal energy, more and more life will flow. Look at Amrita Andamayi. Yeah. Okay. She has studied only 4th standard. Millions of people come to her. Why? The energy flows actually. Just flows. So please understand what is the purpose of life. The purpose of life is to be happy, to be peaceful. Okay. And to be happy and to be peaceful will happen when you discover your own true nature, which is called Atmatman. So that discovering your true nature is called Shiva. The consciousness is called Shiva. The power of consciousness is called Shakti. The power of consciousness is the world. So discover Shiva in you and discover Shakti. That is the purpose of life. That's the father and mother God. So not the puja what you do. You have to discover that Shiva consciousness in you and discover the Shakti which flows out of it, you. That is the realization of God. 50% realization will not be complete. Just discover self consciousness. The consciousness and power of the consciousness you have to discover. Power of consciousness is called Shakti. The consciousness is called Shiva. Fire and the ability of the fire to burn is Shakti. Fire is Shaktiman. Ability of the fire to burn is called Shakti. Knowing yourself is called Shiva. Okay? And discovering the power of Shiva is called Shakti. That's the realization of father and mother. So the realization is, yesterday you had an understanding that you are not the role. Right? Today we go through one more discovery. Okay? Before that, I want you to, now we want to what I meant by vision and mission. Is it clear? Vision clear? Is it clear to anybody? Anybody has a doubt or don't agree with that? Sounds fine. Abhishek? Clear? Okay, can you sit, close your eyes and first see what unique skills you have, very, very special skills you have. You may have very special skills of doing something for yourself. Now with that special skill what you have, can you bring peace and happiness to people? That is your vision. Is it clear? It may be 10 people, it may be 15 people, it may be 100 people, don't worry about that. How many people you can bring that peace and happiness with your skill is your vision. Are you clear? Can you close your eyes, sit silently and see what is your vision in life? Katyani, you understood what I'm saying? Do it. You have to make one line statement, don't make a paragraph. One line statement of your vision clearly.
Those who have completed, keep this right down and open your eyes. So who could not complete the vision? Can you please raise your hands? Okay. You did. Anybody else?
Make them better engineer, But in that process, like if I'm on, I want to teach a lot of students and
perfect.
So making money is a
it's a without making money, we will not be able to do it.
No, maybe I'm also working. So
it's okay.
I can work, but that's also okay.
That's okay. I got it. Yeah. Okay. So, yeah, you can go one round, we can ask people. Okay. Who is the one to start?
I want to help people discover more information by contributing my technical skills, so like contributing to Wikipedia or contributing to open source in technical terms.
Okay. I want to help people in a technical way. I don't know how, but I will. And also, I want to help orphan people.
What is your unique skill that you have to state very clearly? You have a unique skill that you have to state clearly. Right? That's important. I want to help people. Their skill is that is actually your compassion, love. This is the skill which I have to apply. That is what you have to state. You have to discover your skills, or rather, you have to discover your gifts, then you have to share the gifts. What gifts you have? Now you come around, by the time you contemplate. Okay? Yeah, Abhishek, completed. Right? The gift you have is ability for engineering skills.
Yeah. Yeah.
So
I want to
but in process make money.
Sure. That's
right.
Okay.
My skills are teaching and leading. For teaching, to teach children Bhagavad Gita and some life skills. And make for leading skills, make one center for spiritual skills.
Very good.
To see minds on as many people as possible by listening to their sorrows that have been.
Okay, good. Maitri, state clearly.
I want to help all the animals.
What is the skill you have?
Helping.
So, I may have to give slight more details, because I have dedicated my for Seva, and myself and my wife Vidya Shalin, we are doing Seva to Seva. That is an organization called India Love Foundation. They are having a lot big vision of doing good for the country, because it's an international satsang group, and all satsang is remaining outside, they want to do seva for India, Indian students, and I am coordinating that work for all of them. So we have dedicated our life to that by doing seva. That is two things we have taken for that. That is one is conducting workshops in all the 600 Navodaya schools in India, and sending them books, at least 300, 400 books to each schools. We are doing that, and we are doing it as our seva to that organization. So, as a part of the our vision and mission, vision is already there to do seva to build up the next generation. Because if we do this seva to the students, they will be our future citizens. So, to bring out nobility out of those students who are studying in these Navodaya schools, they are of basically from a village background. So we expect them to be, they become noble and do service to their country. So that is the silver lining for our country. That is our vision, of course. So it is our part I am just bringing out. So we wanted to distribute at least one organization is there. There 500 books are there in Kannada and 100 books are there in English. So our intention is to send those 500 books to each of the 30 Navodaya Vidyalayas during this year, and 100 books for because they are English, they can be sent to outside. That's for 600 schools for next 2 or 3 years. Now, we were working on that. Now, I have changed my vision for this year, because it's a part of ongoing seva. Now, we wanted to send for 30 JVs and for 200 schools by this year. Now, see, doing doing this seva, we are binding those books and sending them. As it is, we are not sending the books. So we used to do that. And this is for the last about 1 month, Mr. Babu Prabhu and Mrs. Babu Prabhu joined with us for doing that seva. And that has created a lot of energy in us. Instead of sending the planning, we have planned to do send the, this 30 JPs in next 3 months. But within the last month, we could do that, complete the seva. This is the energy that has been generated by jointly doing seva. That's what I wanted to just bring it to your knowledge. So we have already sent 30, 500 books to 30, 500 each books, 500 each to 30 JPs during last 1 month. We have already started the work of sending 100 books to 200 JPs in the next 1 year. But the way in which we are doing now, I think we can finish it by this year we had planned. But as a part of the mission, that our own, how we can do that, I think that we can send 40,000 books, 600 JPs are there. By the year end, we can bind those books, 100 books each to each JP, and complete the process within the year end, that is by March. This is the mission I have now planning, because by doing this seva, all the students are, because we have conduct workshops, that's our planning, doing workshops in all the 600. We have planned to do it in next 5 years. But with our efforts, we have done it in 150 JPs by now, by this year. And we are planning to do it in 200 JPs during next 1 year. That we are already doing. But sending books was a big problem. So I think the effort that we are putting in now, and with the larger vision, with the greater energy, I want to do it faster and complete sending of these books within the next year to all the 600 JPs. Thank you.
I have organizing skills, besides financial skills, organizing skills. So my vision is, through my organizing skills, help develop the Light of the Self Foundation as a parent body and enable, spread its activities to a wider section of the society.
I am having an exceptional property in one village. I want to develop my green park, building facilities, and those who come from the outside, they can stay there, do their pujas and all. And if possible, I want to construct my pyramid also, and do some meditation classes and all these things in that place.
My vision is to open a hostel in my village for the benefit of students there. And apart from that, I am having the skill of naturopathy. So conduct the naturopathy classes. And farming also, natural farming, to give rares that knowledge of naturopathy. That's fine.
Actually, he is a very good naturopath teacher. I would request somebody to organize classes. We can, a couple of people, we can learn the food, food, make food and naturopathy.
For that, I am planning to conduct a raw dye workshop, that is a dye workshop on 2nd October. I am planning it. 2nd October in PTM level. So I will inform later. Thank you.
The unique skill what I have is related to fitness. My vision is will guide people in reaching their fitness goal.
I have one important skill bestowed by God is helping people. I'm good at setting big goals, visions. Most important thing is the perseverance which is required to achieve those goals. I have it in my dreams. So I'm actually living my dream right now. I'm doing what I always wanted to do, create something very big. But I have a bigger vision which I had not told anyone. That vision is to create a center of excellence for practical sciences. So, something like Carnegie Mellon University. We don't have anything in India which is of that standard. So, since I keep traveling to the US and like to Pittsburgh a lot, and I have visited Carnegie Mellon University. And the first time I visited that university, I always felt that I should try to do something like that. And I have taken some baby steps towards that.
The skill I have is I know everything that is to know about making films. My vision is to make films which teach people how to be or how to live. But making films involves a lot of money, and with a lot of money comes a lot of other ways. So that's what keeps me, pushed back. But I will contemplate more about it, and I surely hope to at least make 10 movies in the next 10 years.
Okay, just it's a good vision. So along with vision, you put a limitation also. Okay, limitation is making a movie involves a lot of money. That is not a real limitation. Okay, that is a limitation which is brought in by your ego and your mind. So next session I am going to show you how to break that limitation. It's a belief, okay, which is not true. So all beliefs are false. So how to take a true belief and work with that is what I am going to teach next session. It's good that you brought out the belief, because next session is going to be how our limiting beliefs are limiting us and how to break them open.
So already I am teaching bhajan.
So your vision is clear. You have to make a vision. I want to teach 100 children, 500 children next 1 year. It should be more clear.
And
that's next one.
And go to sell for the future.
You have social interaction skills.
Skills, and my comfort zone is home. So I really want to make my home as a table in Australia, where it's just to share and spread peace, happiness, love, and wisdom. With my actions, words, and thoughts. And
my vision, I have been thinking about it for a very long time, and I have always found myself in a peaceful place where I can see myself surrounded by children. I'm looking at doing something towards this. I want to have an orphanage where I'm able to help children, thereby where I can teach them to help in similar situations. The skill I have, I'm not too clear about that, but I have been told that I'm a very good listener, so people come to me with they are in stress, they kind of come to me. So I'm like a sounding board.
It's said that the ladies educated, the whole family is educated. It was not a literary sense for me. But in the recent couple of years, that was a true experience, what I was have seen, how if women are distressed at home or anywhere and they feel left out, even the children get affected. The whole, even they are related to the children and everything.
So with that vision was, I want to guide as many women to make them feel empowered, to understand the gaps what they have, maybe sharing my mapping knowledge or relationship building skills.
My vision is, I want to become a pilot when I grow up.
Okay.
And take people on place from that. Now I can just teach some workshops or something.
What is your vision? What you want to make happen in the world? That's your vision. So what is that you want? What is it I can make happen? No. What is that you want to make happen?
Make them have their own talents.
Have their? What is your? Have their? What is the unique skill which you have? What is the ability gift which you have? Creative arts. Right? Using creative arts, how you can make feel peace and happiness is a vision. So how do you do that? By two process of teaching. So then what is your unique skill? Art is your skill that you want to develop, teach as a skill to help people. Develop. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Excuse me.
Visualize
is seen. I don't know at what point of time they will see, but the drive will be in that manner. And what I was doing is, maybe luckily I am in a teaching profession. My formal duty is to impart knowledge in my area. Simultaneously, informally, I always keep teaching hundreds and thousands of children, not children, there are adolescents whom I teach. All these ways through which you can lead a meaningful life so that you all can form a meaningful society. And my strong point is having the burning desire, extension of my human resource to any extent, having patience, and at any cost wanting to see that we transform people so that they lead a meaningful life, so that a meaningful society is established. And this idea is property. That's the essence of it. Thank you.
Skills are teaching particularly science and mathematics.
Apart from that, I focus on a bit of environment as well, and compassion to others, happiness, and teaching them how to be comfortable in some way. I am part of a couple of communities in MITRE. We have something called the MITRE Foundation, where we identify some rural schools, where the kids will not have basic things like books, or maybe they won't be interested in having chappals. I mean, this is the reality. They'll be coming to schools without slippers. And barefoot, and they would be longing for bags or some games, carom board or whatever. We identify, we take wish lists from them, and we collect donations from all the whoever is willing to contribute from MITRE, and give them all this, whatever they request for, we give them all this. So this is one activity which we always engage. This is on a regular basis we do this. And apart from that, I'm part of a green community as well, where we try to contribute towards contribute towards the environment. And I would prefer to continue on this and contribute towards educating
artists.
I don't prefer to donate, and I'll continue to donate for educating artists.
What is your skill?
My skill is a bit of teaching, and I do one cycle, sir. I don't know how I can relate one cycle, sir.
What is
it? One cycle.
See, the thing is, this is actually two ways of thinking. When you start, way of thinking. When you do the service of bring it to the world, with your skill, the skill also grows actually. Okay, otherwise there's a conflict. Okay, I have this skill, but I do something else, then you won't be able to sustain it, because there's a clash up, right? If you have a teaching skill, and you say, I'll donate the money, the teaching skill will not grow, it'll die. Both will die. You cannot donate the money, neither your teaching skill increase. Always you should do something by which your skill also grows and the contribution takes place. Otherwise you can't sustain that.
I'll start teaching, going to schools and organizes or something.
So that's where you have to focus on, okay? Yeah. It should be both ways. It should nourish each other. Otherwise, it will see, you say, I start donating the money, it will be in the limitation very soon. You understand? It is very important that what skills you have to use it properly. In the process, your skill will grow. Actually, I keep saying, I have taught so many students. I don't know how many students got enlightened. At least I got enlightened and I became a better teacher than their father. So in the process you will improve.
And also I want to contribute towards success in terms of translations. Some activities which require.
So you should make, if you're teaching your portion, your entire service attitude centered on teaching in whatever way. Rest is all multiple things. That's what you won't be able to sustain that. Only if you have what is your strength, only you will come to each other. Okay, your weakness will not fade away. Are you clear? Is this still to everybody? You should focus on what area is your gift and focus on working out. Let's say your gift is teaching children. Then you say, I donate the children, money to children, then you both will die. You will donate 50 rupees, 100 rupees, 1000 rupees, that's all gone. But if your skill is there, then you, by the more you contribute, it will grow. So please understand the principle. This is called yatna. The more you give, the more you grow. That is actually what God is, a gift of God. The more you give, you become poor, then it's not. Say, I want to donate 10,000 rupees. You can donate 10,000 rupees, it's gone. After that, you can't do anything. Right? But if you start using your skill, that skill will grow and people who get benefited will also grow. That is the gift of God. Is it what you say? You understand? Have you understood, Kathy, what I say? Right? Let's say you say, I'll donate some money to the charity. You can't do that. After one time, you can't do that. But if you say, teaching is my skill, art is my skill, I combine this to teach more people, then it will grow. Both the skill will grow and people also will benefit will grow. Is it clear? Understand? Anybody else? Everybody is clear about this?
Action. If your actual skill grows, then only you can sustain it for a long time.
Otherwise, it won't.
And otherwise, you won't get the passion to actually do it.
You will die, both will die. Your skill will die, and the activity you do is also will die.
Because the passion which I have for your teaching, the engineering students, because in turn, I will actually myself always be abreast to and the latest with the newer thinking. And
Gayatri and Subha, I am coming to you people. Don't think that I have, you are out of sight.
What has happened is over the period of so many years of being in the field of coaching and counseling, I found that a lot of professionals especially are facing this issue of always being in anxiety, fear and worry. Now, I also derived something out of it for myself in the whole process. So now I have created a vision to help people to live in assured state. That is, life is a game rather than life is an exam. So anxiety, fear and worry are a part of the exams actually. And that becomes a part of our psyche. And it has become a part of our psyche. And where we continue to perpetually live with anxiety, fear and worry. So how to get people out of it is something which I derived as a model. So the vision is to help people to live in assured state through my unique skill of deriving models on being in assured state and coaching. That's what is my vision.
Okay. Okay, now we'll come back to Subbu and Gayatri for heading for that.
This is too pressure.
What's up this time? What is it? Okay.
My mission is to make everyone in the world know that they are consciousness through t-shirts.
Oh! T-shirts. He's a very good, he designs t-shirts very well. Gayatri, have you kept a t-shirt here?
No, sir.
Why? Yeah, you should actually.
I actually know any t-shirt.
Okay, good.
Very
so,
guys, sustain
their skills.
What's up? Okay. My mission is to help the
good generation. Okay. Okay, Gayatri, come with me. We'll operate camera for you. Come. You talk.
Wait for a second. To turn camera. Yeah. Go back. Okay, tell. Tell, Amma.
To be a part of your mission.
Okay. See, please understand, your vision, your skills should nourish each other. If it is not nourishing, it is not your vision. Okay? Right? And the vision is something which you have to be able to do lifelong, not one time. If you are doing one time, it's not vision. Okay? It's a charity. Understand? Till you die, if you do that, it's called vision. After you do it, you die, somebody else does your vision, that means your vision has been able to bring energy to many more people. If your vision dies after your death, so that means still it's a limited vision. The vision should be broad enough, energizing so many people, so that it will bring the energy many more people even after dying. So that is a bigger vision. Everybody has a, is the vision is clear, right? Anybody has a question? Okay, we came back. Yeah, come back to Vaishal. You thought about what I said?
Yeah,
I think my field is to manage people, right management type, okay. And organizing and
coordinate. So maybe I can open an orphanage organization, or I can help to get some kind of donation.
Thank you. So, now
we
are clear about vision.
Huh?
Yeah, event management, all those things.
Good people. She forces me all the time to do things which I didn't do. So I know she can get things done from people.
Okay. Okay, so let's give a big round of applause to all the people. It is very, very important to have a vision, clear vision. Okay? So people ask me year after year, month after month, day after day, how I get up and do these classes. That's because of vision. Okay? The vision gives me energy. My energy I pass on to people and they give me back energy. That's how it happens. Okay? So the more people I energize, the more energy I get. That's the law of the universe. The more you give, the more you get. That's really vision. So then, please understand, you are in tune with God. Okay? Otherwise, you are out of tune with God. The energy supply gets cut off somewhere. The engine gets stopped. Okay? This is the way you operate in tune with the universe. Understand? A clarity of purpose, clarity of vision. Now we'll understand what all blocks which can come in the path of vision. So, who was that Kartikeya, right? By teaching art, your skills of art will grow?
Yes.
Right? Then it can be vision. Understand? If it doesn't grow, then it won't be vision. If it becomes a block for you, it doesn't vision. Okay?
Yes.
So Maitri, by dog, helping dogs, how your skills will grow?
Taking care of them.
By helping animals, what is the skill which you apply and how it will grow? That question you have to ask. Have you understood what I'm saying? You can take care of them, you will generate enough money. To take care of them, you need money, right?
No.
No money is required.
I mean, if there are some centers where there are pet animals, where they get, like there is a dog.
Okay, then what happened to your studies and engineering job? Will it be affected? So, you have to synchronize this. How you do it, you have to find out, okay? Okay? So,
I want to
help
buy more pets and keep more pets
in which you can keep more pets in which that I can handle. See, my friend, if you have love towards pet animals, you also have compassion towards fellow human beings. So that compassion to animals which you extend will help you to have compassion with all fellow human beings. So that is how that skill within you will help you to spread that feeling of compassion. So that every human being needs to be compassionate with all fellow human beings with whom they interact in life. That spreading of that feeling of compassion, that's what grows manifold.
Voluntary and otherwise, so
you
can be in touch with
him,
he can
help you. So that's how the God used the gift. The moment you are clear, you state your purpose, something will come. Understand? Okay? Pita. See, please understand. When you discover Shiva in you, when you discover consciousness in you, you become peaceful. Okay? When you discover consciousness, you will become peaceful, you become liberated. When you fall in line with the consciousness, the action of the consciousness of God in the world, Shakti in you increases. You become larger than what you are. Discovering Shiva and Shakti, that's the purpose of life. Okay, so do you have a break or we'll go continue the next session?
Vision is the Shiva and the purpose is Shiva.
No,
okay, if you want a break, we can have a break, otherwise we'll continue the next session. I'll go into execution part. How to convert this vision into reality, right? First problem we face is we have a limitation of belief. Okay, we believe in certain things, is possible, not possible. Negative attitude means believing something is not possible, right? Those things you have to address before you proceed. You said making films requires millions of dollars, money. No. By making films you earn that. That's the other way.
Actually, nowadays making films due to advancement of technology, it's so possible to make film in a low budget. That was not possible. There's a new movie called Ship of Theseus that recently came out, which was on a very low budget, and it's a very nice film.
So they believe that making films requires money,
yes,
is not true. Okay? That's true for any of us. All this is purpose is to break all your limitation. Because you are all divine consciousness, God consciousness. There's no limit for you. The limit is imposed by your own belief systems. The breaking of the belief system is next class is about. Okay? Yeah, we can
ask.
Okay, share the question. Yeah. So what is the... who is the white man?
Mike Man is gone abroad.
To achieve the vision, motivation is required.
To achieve what?
Vision.
Yeah. So to achieve vision, motivation is required. How many people believe that?
The vision is
not clear. No. I'll tell you. How many people believe that to achieve vision, you need a motivation? How many people believe that?
Motivation is within.
Okay, let us understand what is motivation, right? You have to understand what is motivation. Motivation is something which makes me feel comfortable, happy if I do. That is my motivation. The fear also can be motivation. Vaishali, can you run? He runs here every day. He cycles about 50 kilometers, right?
Yeah.
50 kilometers he does, right? So can you do that 50 kilometers? 2 kilometers? 5 kilometers? 30? Come here. So if you don't run 50 kilometers, I'll beat you. The motivation can be fear. Vaishali, if you don't run 50 kilometers, I'll kill you.
Then also, sir, I can say that if you kill me, because I can't anyway.
But you won't say. If the threat is real threat, you'll not say.
No,
that's because 50 kilometers you think it's killing anyway. Either way, I'll say 35 kilometers. Then you don't die also.
If the lion is coming behind you,
you are not only useful.
But then at one point you
will
fail.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm saying that's not a border case. You'll use a border case. 30 kilometers, you'll neither die or lie, will you? Then you'll run. Okay, so fear is one motivator. Is fear motivated in your life? What kind of fear is there? So, fear is one motivator, okay? Then second motivator for you is benefit. I'll get some benefit out of that, right? So benefit, one benefit is it? Paisa. It's okay. Money is what I get, is good benefit, no questions. So the benefit she gets is compassion, okay? So somebody else has some benefit, making, developing compassion, love, is a benefit. So the motivation is always proportional to the amount of fear or amount of benefit. Correct? In the process of doing that, you become a better person. Okay? So by organizing something, you become a better organizer. One day you may organize a national event, another day you may organize an international event, you become a better organizer. Very simple.
But if we get response, definitely
you can. You will get response. Why? How to get response, how it works out is next step. You keep this question, right? First, motivation is clear. Your motivation to make tomorrow morning to get up and do some service. With this, by doing that, you should become better and better. That's the whole idea. If you don't become better and better, it's not correct, right? You say, I will do service, my big hubby is there, big boss is there here. Okay, every month I will take 10,000 rupees from his pocket and do charity. Right? So one day the 10,000 will get cut. So you can't do charity. So the whole purpose is that something which can continuously motivate you, continuously energize you, and continues to do service longer after time, month after month. That's what you have to choose. You have to grow with that.
But people around us also has to motivate, right?
No, the moment you say this is, you have become clear, some help will come. So for example, she stated that she wants to help neighbors. Immediately help from here, here, it will come. It will come from 10 different places. That's what I'm saying. You are actually thinking you are a body. You are more than a body. You are consciousness. You are God. So that power will come to you. The power of divine will come to you. Okay. We'll give 10 minutes break. After that, we'll take beliefs and how they affect us. Now, what is the time? 12 minutes break. Okay. Yeah. What time? For now.
Then we can break away.
Yes,
mm-hmm. Yeah.
So lunch is at 12 o'clock, half an hour we'll continue and after that we'll take a break. Okay?
1 o'clock.
Lunch is at 1 o'clock. Okay. So I'll show you a small PowerPoint, then we'll have a discussion around that, then we'll see how we can proceed.
Okay, shoot.
No break.
Because half an hour we'll break for lunch.
No,
how many cells are there in left hand?
One.
How many cells are there in the brain?
1 billion.
1 billion. And how many connections are there in your brain? 1 billion. How many connections are there in your brain? Is more than a trillion, which is actually more than number of stars, planets and galaxies in the universe. Is it clear? So, when you say myself, which self you spoke of? How many actions took place to lift your left hand? Millions of actions took place. And how many you did actually out of that? How much was yours? And you say myself? So, what you said is correct. Myself is correct. Okay, the myself has lot more than myself than you know. Okay, there is a conscious self, there's a subconscious self, there's an unconscious self, and there's a superconscious self, God. So these together is myself. So which self you spoke of myself?
Conscious
self. Which is small version. Do you understand? Is clear? Which self is that? So there, to just even lift your hand, and millions of actions have to take place that you don't do consciously, right? Obviously, some self is operating. So that self is awareness is about, this class is about. Is it clear? So myself, what you know, is only this much. No, go to who is. So who is in charge of your life? Obviously, all married men know. Okay? Next slide. So there was one experiment done by a guy called Libet. Okay, which is one of the nice experiments. Where he put a probe to the brain to measure what signals are going to the, what signals are generated. Okay? So, if you say, I lift my hand, before you lift your hand, about 2 seconds back, the action has happened. The signals have gone to the hand. Do you understand what I'm saying? Before you say, I am doing this, I want to do this, before that, 2 seconds back, the whole action has initiated. You understand what I'm saying?
Before one became conscious of that action.
Yes. So, just run the video.
The secrets.
So this small video clip you can see.
We all have this very strong belief that we have conscious free will. And it's a central part of our very strong belief that we can want to do, it's a central part of our orientation ourselves as individuals. And then that we can want to do something, we can have an intention to do something, and then we can do it. We can make our intention drive our actions. And Benjamin Libet's work was one of the few experiments which made a truly innovative and courageous attempt to address that question.
Computer being found. Patrick Haggard's team are going to measure my brain activity in the run-up to a conscious decision.
with electrodes placed on my scalp.
Okay, Susan, you're all wired up and ready to go.
Absolutely.
We're going to record from your left motor cortex, mm-hmm. your right motor cortex, and from the midline. Mm-hmm. I want you to watch the clock hand, which mm-hmm. is rotating in this small clock in the center of the screen. Mm-hmm. And then, at any time that you choose, when you intend mm-hmm. and will to, mm-hmm. I want you to press either this key or this key.
As
the urge takes you.
Fine, okay.
And then the computer will prompt you to type in the position of the clock hand at which you first felt the conscious will to press the button.
Good.
Any questions?
Yeah.
Off we go.
It's very funny waiting for the urge, isn't it? So watching the clock, I record the exact time that I make the decision to act, while the electrodes on my head monitor the activity of my brain leading up to this decision. As I do this over and over again, a clear pattern starts to emerge.
Contain the same basic effect as Libet originally found. The average time of the intention to move was where this arrow is here.
So you can see this graph, this is about, this is minus 2 seconds. That means the lady decided to press the button at this point of time, okay? But before she said, I decided to lift my finger, 2 seconds before that, here, already the brain is sending signals to hand to lift. So the decision to lift, I decided to lift my finger, happened after the decision is taken by the body. Is it clear? What's your name? Did you understand what is the meaning of this?
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
So then you say, I lifted my hand. Who lifted your hand? Myself, you said. Yes. Who?
Consciousness.
Consciousness, which is much larger than what you know as yourself. Is it clear? Understand? What you know of yourself is only a small portion of what is yourself. Right? This decision, even a simple decision like lifting the finger, is already happening before you consciously come across that. So when you say, I did it, you are putting a stamp on already or some decision which is taking place. Is it clear? So how many of decisions are your own decisions, my dear? Please let's lift your hand. I like this. Who likes this? I decided to do
that
this.
Is also I.
Yeah, but which I? Not the I you know. The question is, there is I which you don't know. When you say I did this, you are speaking of I which you know. I am speaking of I which you don't know.
No, but that I which I don't know
is also I. Is also I. All that I am pointing out is, that is a part of the I, which is you don't know. The decision is happening through that process. Is it clear? Next question. Stop.
Before the action actually occurs.
You go to next step. Next step. The slide is there. So there is a part of you which you know and there is a part of you which you don't know. Which is larger? What you know is larger or what you don't know is larger?
I don't know.
Go next. What you call as conscious mind is less than 5% of your mind. What you don't know as conscious, what you don't know or what is hidden in you is subconscious mind, which is more than 95%. So when you say, I did it, who did it? The one who knows or one who doesn't, one whom you don't know. Right? This portion of you is much larger, much more powerful, and that takes a lot of decisions for you. So what is there in this? We'll see. Go next. The subconscious, which forms about 80% to 90% of our mind, has multiple layers. The conscious mind, what you know, is here. It's more of short-term memories, decision making, and subconscious mind is, once your mind consists of memories stored in various formats, which are long-term memories. I still remember the aroma of the coffee, very nice coffee, filtered coffee, right? Memory is stored as smell. I still remember this old romantic songs of Rajesh Khanna, the sound. So some of these memories we stored in our mind, okay? Now these memories are not stored fully, but they are actually filtered versions, censored versions which are stored. Then early childhood memories where you had what you call as you interact with the people, maybe your parents, maybe your grandparents. You didn't have any discrimination and whatever they gave, whatever interactions you had becomes your positive and negative associations. Somebody gives a good toffee, a black color toffee, so you associate black color with the good. Some toffee you don't like red color, you say it's negative. So that comes to your consciousness even after growing up. You say, I like red color, I like black color. Why? I don't know. Some of these memories. Right? Then of course, deepest level, you have your primitive urges, primitive memories of survival. Okay? Survival of struggle for existence. Fight or flight. So but most of the time you operate from the below the subconscious level, below the conscious mind. And many of the decisions which you have taken appear to be taken, decisions will appear to be taken by you, but already it's taken by some of the stored elements. Nothing wrong with that or right about that. I'm just pointing out this is how it is. Right? But that becomes a problem. I don't want to get angry, but I am getting angry. Who says I don't want to get angry? The 5% fellow. The top 5%. Who is getting, who anger is coming from where?
Subconscious mind.
Impressions. Clear? As long as they are in tune, there's no problem. But you say most of the time, I don't want to get angry, I am depressed, I don't want to get depressed. Right? So can we become aware of more and more about ourselves, what you call myself? Some 5% can you become 6%, 7% or 8%, or probably 40%, or probably 50%. That is actually your spiritual journey, becoming aware of yourself.
So positive thoughts which you think, like suppose if I'm getting angry, I think, oh, I should not get angry. Mm-hmm. And these are positive thoughts or some negative positive reaffirmations.
Right.
So do they go down subconscious mind?
Yes.
By keep saying and by
yes.
When you become angry, then
yes.
Remembering that.
Yes.
Going down subconscious.
So conscious mind is actually the boss. So he can instruct the subconscious mind. But sometimes there is a conflict of interest internally. What you tell now versus what you have earlier. The clash is there, the resolution has to happen. Right? And so this, whatever you say, it gets filtered. I'll tell you how it gets filtered out. It doesn't go straight there, down there.
So it means that from the conscious mind, positive thoughts come,
And from the subconscious mind, negative thoughts.
No. Subconscious mind is negative. Neither positive nor negative. Subconscious mind is your. It's a help for you. It's a recording. It's memories. Okay. It's neither positive or negative about it. Okay. It helps you. But only problem is, let's say you have a very good powerful car. Okay. And car brake you don't know. So then what happened to the car? Car is good. So subconscious mind is like a car. It is good, but if you don't know where to stop, how to stop, or how to control it, then you will be in problem. Okay, next thing. So this is just to bring little bit clarity about meditation. Next thing. So they measure the signals to the brain, okay, by putting instruments to the brain. Come on, next. So there are five different types of brain waves are measured. They are called beta, alpha, theta, delta, and gamma. At beta, the frequency is 14 hertz to 26 hertz. That means if you brain wave measure, it will go 14 cycles per second to 26 cycles per second. Okay? So this is your active state. Now what you are in a beta state. Clear? If you do a little bit relaxation in meditation, it comes down to 13 to 8. Okay? If you go deeper into meditation or if you're drowsy in sleep, it'll be 7 to 4. It's called theta. If you go deeper in sleep, it's 3 to 0.5. It's a delta. Okay? And if you get excited, which is actually excited means not excitement, is not anger, not jealousy, angry, that type of excitement. It's an excited high state of concentration where a super fast learning can take place. That's called gamma. So this actually above this is more of full awareness. Below this is going deeper into your subconscious. Now if you go deeper here without awareness, without conscious awareness, then it's called sleep. With consciousness awareness, if you are able to go down here, it's called meditation. Are you clear? You are able to see yourself different states at a deeper level with awareness. It's called meditation. So meditation is deep sleep with awareness. Meditation is conscious sleep. Sleep is unconscious meditation. Do you understand the difference? If you lose your consciousness, it becomes sleep. If you are aware, it becomes meditation. If you are aware and become relaxed deep down, it's called meditation. If you lose your awareness and go deep down, it's called sleep. Have you understood, everybody? Have you understood? Now, what is the importance of going deep down with awareness?
Siddhi.
Huh?
Siddhi.
Then you become aware of your subconscious and unconscious operation of the mind. You understand? You become aware of the mind. From 5% your awareness goes, increases. Is it clear to everybody? So right now you are become only awareness is only at the top, conscious 5%. That awareness spreads to deeper level of your own life. So everybody does a meditation every day. What is that meditation called? Sleep. Because you are not aware, in that sleep meditation, you will not get any wisdom. You understand? The only wisdom you can gain is about yourself. And that yourself meditation wisdom will happen only when with the awareness you will go deeper. Without awareness, if you go deep, the same personality will come back. So the meditation is that as person become meditative, his personality changes because his understanding of himself, which is 5%, changes. Is it clear to everybody? Gayatri?
Yes,
sir. It's clear? So you have to know how to relax, go deeper and deeper with awareness. Then whatever is, I showed you 95% what is there earlier, that becomes more and more clear. Now you say, I am getting angry, how to control the anger. Aray Papa, you don't know why you are getting angry. Already you have deep inside, some lot of things are hidden. Once you become aware of that, you can become free from that. Awareness is freedom. Unawareness is bondage. Right? So as a person becomes meditative, he becomes more and more aware of his own self, deeper self. Clear? Next thing.
Sir, even when I sleep, I get my subconscious imprints actually come in form of dreams.
Yeah.
And I remember some of them in morning.
Yeah.
But why do there is no wisdom which actually comes with it?
There's some amount of wisdom there. Because subconscious dreams, when it comes, subconscious things when come to the
So dreams are nothing but subconscious things, right?
Subconscious mind.
Or they are, there can be other than...
No. Dreams are subconscious. Or probably unconscious. They can come from unconscious also.
Uh-huh.
They are a communication to your conscious mind.
So then when I remember it, why there is no wisdom?
No. When you're remembering it, it won't help. You understand the message, it will help.
No, I get any random dream and then...
No. Random dream is a communication from your subconscious mind to conscious mind. You become aware of the message, that's a transformation. Just because somebody meditates...
How this is different, meditation is different from sleep in terms of developing wisdom, because both the places, I can remember the dream, I can remember the imprints, and how it will transform.
No, difference in the meditation is... You are not participating in the dream, okay? In dream you are participating. So I'll give you an example of meditation and dream difference, okay? It's a good question he has asked. Now let us close your eyes and listen carefully. You close your eyes and visualize one day in your life, maybe one important moment in your life, okay? You see that moment in your life and see as if it is you are participating in the dream. Understand? Let's say the most important moment in your life is you went to a park, beautiful park. So you recollect that event, visualize that event now. Are you clear? Bring back the experience now. Clear? Do you understand what I'm saying? A participatory dream. Okay? Do that. Open your eyes. Everybody did that?
Yes.
Yeah? Recollected the experience? Now, you go back to the same scenario. You see that same scenario as if it is happening on a television screen. You understand? It is non-participating. As if it is happening in a TV screen. Is it clear? The difference is clear? Okay. Do that as if it is not happening in a... Visualize as if it is happening in a TV screen or cinema projection.
With
yourself as observer, not your, with yourself as a character.
Yeah.
It's non-participatory. It's a more of a movie. Observe it as a movie.
So the mind is going to the past.
So open your eyes. What is the difference in these two scenarios?
When I was just observing, the emotions were not attached to it. I just
Correct.
Myself as if
Right. So In the second case, there was no emotion attached. How many people know that? How many people like notice that? Right? That meditation is a witnessing of your memories. Dream is participation in your memories. When you participate in your memories, there's emotions attached and the noticing becomes very blurred. What I'm saying? When you are intention, you don't notice. But when you are not intention, you are witnessing. You will be able to notice many more details than that. Are you, what I'm saying?
When you wake up,
yeah.
Then you can observe it. Whatever you see in a dream, when you wake up, you can see it as a... You will again be watching it, okay, I got this.
Yeah, so only difference is, what happens is that when you wake up, only a part of that comes to your consciousness. Some part of that is gone, already lost. Only highlight will be something is this thing. So you are missing the whole picture. In meditation, gradually what happens is you learn to appreciate the entire picture without participating in that. That's why meditation is becoming a witness to your life. Now you are not witness to your life, you are a participant to your life. What is? How to find the message? So that I'll teach you. That you want, you can. I'll teach you. Because subconscious mind has a communication language. The language of subconscious mind is images. Okay, how to understand the images, I can teach you separately. Okay. Subconscious mind has the many messages which come in the form of images. The language of subconscious, if you understand, you can understand the dreams. Okay. But that's not important. You learn meditation, then you'll understand subconscious much more better than dreams.
Clear? So if I'm seeing one tiger actually who is wealthy
and...
Then what is the message?
It could be your boss who is coming as a tiger. It could be your wife who is coming as a tiger. Or it could be your father-in-law who is coming as a tiger. You have to find out what that tiger is about. Subconscious mind is giving a message in some form that something fearful is coming to you. What is that fearful?
I don't
know. Huh? I am saying the tiger represents your fears, some of the form of fears. Okay. It can be various different messages. It's ultimately it communicates to you through the images. The image you want to relate to your real life. Okay? So is it clear to everybody? Any questions? Okay. Next step. Go next step. So our life is, we have a big guy here. What is this guy? 95%. And this is the guy whom you think you are. Okay? And who is running the show? So, many times we consciously we want, but subconsciously we don't want. So ultimately what comes is, don't want. Okay.
How to find that
is what I'm teaching now. First you become aware what's happening, right? So far you are very confident myself. Now I want to ask you which self?
At times you feel my gut feeling is saying something.
Yeah.
That is something subconscious mind?
Yes. Right? Gut feeling is gives a message. Okay, interpreting a fellow is this guy. Okay, so this is like a story. Akbar and Birbal were having an argument. Akbar said, who is more powerful, men or women? Okay, so Birbal said, it is women who are always powerful. So then Akbar said, let's have a contest. He said, all the men who don't listen to women, please come. Okay? And all of us also come so that we will have a prize distribution ceremony for the people who don't listen to their women. So almost 10,000 people came. Akbar said, look, how many people have come? And you said, women, they listen to the wife. Then Birbal said, let's make an announcement. Okay. So the guys who have come here, who don't listen to their wife, please lift your hand. Anybody lifts your hand falsely or saying untruth, their head will be cut. And one fellow only lifted his hand like this, not even like this. Okay. So Akbar was very happy. At least one fellow in my kingdom is not listening to his wife. So call that fellow. Birbal, you say you are wrong actually. Then Birbal said, let me ask you. He introduced the question. So, sir, why did you lift your hand? My wife told me to lift his hand, lift my hand when king makes an announcement. That's why I lifted hand. Like that. Who is running in charge of your wife? Please tell me. And you say very clearly, say myself. Which self is that? The conscious self or this self? Who is running your show? Okay. So, but the subconscious is nothing bad or good about it, nothing bad about it, it's a very powerful engine. How to use it to your life, in your life, how to make your life meaningful is what we are discussing. Okay? But the time is over. Is the time up?
Yes, sir.
1 o'clock. Okay. So we'll break for lunch now? We'll break for lunch. Now this is not the end of the story. Okay, your subconscious self is not the end of the story. Your superconscious self is also there. That's how we'll effort you, tell you. Okay, so we are breaking for lunch. We'll have lunch. Yesterday we went to lunch for 1:30, right? If go for lunch, shall we meet at 2:30 or 3 o'clock? 2:30. We'll have lunch and have a small nap and meet at 2:30. Then I'll tell you one more self which you don't know. Super.